So now we're looking at nitrosyl chloride, or NOCl, and it's starting to get a little bit more complicated, but we are just following those exact same rules that we used for our other three Lewis diagrams. So first of all, as always, I'm going to look at how many valence electrons each atom has. So nitrogen in group 15 has 5, oxygen in group 16 has 6, and chlorine in group 17 has 7. So nitrogen needs 3 more valence electrons to be stable. So that means that it's going to be my central atom because it needs the most valence electrons. And I'm going to imagine my 4 areas around nitrogen, and I'm going to add 1 valence electron at a time, moving clockwise, until I get to the top, and I'm going to go around again and add my second electron to the first area. So I have 1 lone pair of electrons and 3 single bonding pairs of electrons. So at this stage, I'm not quite sure what my Lewis diagram is going to look like. So I'm going to change to a pencil if I'm in my exam, because I want to be able to go over easily and tidy it up a little bit at the end. So I have to add my 2 outer atoms, and I'm going to choose areas where there is a single electron around the nitrogen, and I'm just going to spread them out evenly for now. So I'll add my Cl here and my O over here. So then I'm going to come around and add my valence electrons to my chlorine. So I'm going to again move clockwise. I'm not going to start in the area that's next to my single electron for nitrogen. Instead, I'm just going to move 1 step or 1 area clockwise and add my first electron and start moving around until I've added all 7. Then I'm going to come over here and do the same thing for my oxygen. So I'm not going to start over here because there is a single electron for nitrogen in this area. So I'm going to go 1 step clockwise and start here. And I'm going to keep going around until I've added all 6. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to look for areas where the oxygen and the nitrogen both have a single electron, and the same for the chlorine. And I'm going to join those up with a line. So here the nitrogen and the oxygen have a single electron, and here they have a single electron. So the reason I suggested pencil first was so that you can erase any mistakes and go over it to make it look a little bit nicer if you need to. So here, this is a double bond. We have 2 bonds between nitrogen and oxygen, but it doesn't look like it when we have it like this. So instead, we're going to change it to something that looks more like a double bond. And then we could rub out our pencil. So I'm now going to go over everything in pen. And I'm confident that this is correct. But if you weren't confident, then you would just count up your electrons. So in total, we should have 18. And each should have 8 electrons around it so that it's stable. So we've got 2, 4, 6, 8. 2, 4, 6, 8. 2, 4, 6, 8. So each has 8. And in total, we've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. So we know that this is the correct Lewis diagram for NOCl.